From Argyle Technologies. Hello, I'm going to explain you an SNNFE research project called ESMILAT. Before starting to my presentation, I would like to thank you, the Undersecretariat for Turkey, for Defense and Studies of Turkey, for this opportunity. Undersecretariat for Defense Industries, who signed this MILAT project, and other thanks to the ONUS community for this event. Today, I will give a brief introduction of Argela and then Argela's SNNFE experience. Then I will talk about the MILAT R&D project and use cases and key scenarios about MILAT, what we will achieve with this project. Okay, let's start with Argela. Argela is established in 2004. Its headquarters in Istanbul, and we have branches in Ankara, in capital of Turkey, and in Sunnyvale, California. And Argela is fully owned by Türk Telekom. Argela is a Turkish telecom company. Türk Telekom is a service and operates in fixed and mobile networks. And Argela provides solutions and network infrastructure components for telecom operators, public safety, and defense. We are specialized in core networks and in 5G network technologies, and we are generating IPR for these technologies. We have already established a strong presence in the region with solutions in various telecom operators and expanding globally. Now, what we are doing till now. Actually, we are not a new in the SNNFE concepts. We have been following the softwarization concepts from the Jenny project. As you know, Jenny is a project founded by the NSF in USA. And till 2012, when we joined to the ONF, we studied much and densely in the softwarization and SNNFE concepts. In 2012, we started to build our first SNN controller called as YAKAMOS. YAKAMOS is also founded by the TÜBİTAK, which is a national science foundation like NSF. And then 2013, we joined to Sigmara project, Sigmara Plus project, and aims to generalize mobile network architectures with SDN concepts. And in 2014, Argela's first product SENSE is built, and its name is Smart Enterprise Network Solution. And after this product, we have been awarded by many organizations in Turkey by pioneering this concept in the region and in Turkey. In 2015, we contacted with the Undersecretariat for Defense and offered the MILAT project them. It's a 2-year project. We almost passed the 1 year and 1 year left. I will talk about in detail in next slides. By the way, we started the program project in 2015. It's developing in California. It aims to slicing the radio access network, and we are working intensely with the ONLAP, and we are contributing to ENCORD project with this program product. And actually, we are publishing patents and papers in this area. Till now, we have applied 13 papers and 13 patents with the SNNFE concept. And the project, MILAT, actually is an acronym, and can be translated as National Network Technologies. It aims to provide an infrastructure for enabling dynamic cybersecurity and cyber defense mechanisms. And what we'll be dealing here to form a network infrastructure for Turkey's public safety and applications like FirstNet in the USA. And we would like to reduce the dependence on foreign security critical communication infrastructures. And that's why we have to deal with every piece of code, and we have to deliver the code by ourselves. Also, we will provide secret sensitive dynamic configuration abilities attuned to the exigence of military, public defense, and commercial entities. And we will develop general algorithms for security, traffic engineering, and virtualization. Milad also means, in English, is a milestone of the networking, what you can think this project. What we will deliver with this project, in the dotted line, in the red dotted line, we will develop an STM controller and set of network services and network applications. And we will integrate this SDN suite with the NFV measurement infrastructure. We will not deliver the manual, but we will integrate it with a third-party mono projects. We are evaluating now some open sources, OpenBaton, on top of OpenFE and on top of OpenStack. And we will also deliver soft switch. It's based on Intel or DPDK technologies, based on OVS. And potential application domains and sample scenario. Milad, for the first, actually the main aim is, the main potential domain is secure public, national and secure public safety communication infrastructure for Turkey. That's the main aim. And other potential area is national and secure infrastructure for defense and military. Common network and data center infrastructure for all public bodies. Because we are going to produce an STM controller, it's not for a specific area. It aims to work in data center networks, LAN networks, and WAN networks. And we have to fully cover of our requirements in this manner. And we will deal in network infrastructure for commercial operators, which can be shared if necessary. Actually, we offered another project to the same undersecretariat, virtual EPC project. And we are also developing, we have also a project named as ULAC, and this is the 4G and 5G base stations. We are developing this radio access network. And also, another potential domain can be network infrastructure for critical systems like those oil pipeline, nuclear power plants, which requires enhanced cybersecurity mechanisms. And the main scenario is here. When an earthquake occurs in somewhere in Turkey, what we will do here, we will provide here dynamic resource management and dynamic route hopping abilities in the whole Turkey. For example, if there's an earthquake occurred or any emergency situation occurs, what we are going to do in that time, as you can see here, there's router functionalities, firewalls, DPIs, but during the emergency case, you don't need this kind of functionalities. What we will do here, first we will offload the traffic from this node to the other areas, and we will reshuffle the virtual network functions in running in this COPS hardware, and we will deploy router and P-gateway, escape gateway functionalities to that site to enable the communication between the agencies which are doing the critical missions in the emergency situation. Actually, this is my last slide. in other basin. Sorry. This is our team. We have 35 people working in this project now, and 14 people are dealing with the development, core development. And that's all. Simple, I can show you a simple demo. Now, yesterday we show off our applications in the science fair, but I don't know if you can catch it. For example, I can show you an application. We call it root hopping, dynamic root hopping. Yeah, you can see here in Turkey, Turkey map. And we are generating the IPERF traffic between two hosts. As you can see, there will be a traffic between the hosts. Sorry, I couldn't start it. Okay. What are we aiming is in this here? The root hopping algorithm is in the time manner, for example, 30 seconds, is dynamically switching the path to the other available resources. As you can see, it switched the other available paths. It's a simple scenario for the root hopping application. I can answer your questions if you have any.